But surely there are some people you've known way too long to be with. I mean, like, if you've been friends for years, then you already know everything about them. Where's the romance in that?
Yeah, I don't think you can ever actually know everything about someone. Like, that's what keeps it interesting. I mean, like, it's good to understand each other.
Right, so your idea of romance is communication. That's Ben's theory, right?
Well, yeah, like, Ben talks a lot, and so does B, but it's not just the talking. It's like when you don't have to talk.
Right, so you don't want romance, you don't want flowers, you want to be wooed with telepathy.
Well, yeah, like, you can't explain to someone how to get you. You can't sit them down and be like, this is how I am, so this is how you should be. I mean, like, fuck, if people did it like that, like, it's not the point. It's devoid of the point. There's got to be, like, this moment where everything just clicks and you just understand each other.
Words of wisdom, oh wise one. I just hope your future husband gets that too.
Hopefully so, yeah. Right, well, I'm gonna go out.
Why are you off there?
Coffee, kit.
Ooh, nice latte.
I'll come too.
Yeah.
Is that cool?
I mean, it was just kind of casual, like, you won't expect you to
oh,
be
okay,
there.
Sure.
Yeah.
How long do you think you'll be?
Maybe, like, a couple.
I mean, obviously you've got to be back for curfew, but yeah. We could get dinner afterwards, maybe?
Yeah, if you just text me.
Okay.
Yeah, sweet. All right, cool. See you guys later.
See ya. Ben?
Mm-hmm?
Was that conversation, was that kind of off to you? What do you think they're doing?
Making out. Clearly they're in love with one another. Okay. Fred, I know you care a lot about the flat rules, but you're being paranoid. Calm.
Yeah, ha ha ha. Not in front of the camera.
Alrighty. Do you want to keep watching in the flesh?
Sure.
And the camera can be off.
Okay.
Brilliant.
It's now 10:17 p.m. which means that Pisa has broken flat rule number 6. Curfew at 10 p.m. by 17 minutes. Freddy and I are waiting up for him. Balthy's gone to bed though because he's a bit tuckered out from all the fun he's been having with Kit.
I really doubt that he would.
Peter should be home any minute now. And Fred's and I are waiting to leap out and tackle him.
Tackle him intellectually on the repercussions of his actions and their effect on the harmony of the flat.
Yeah. Violence is not okay, kids.
Freddie Kingston approves this message.
What do you think the stars were made of, Freddie, when you were a kid?
I think they were just stars. But I knew that there was a girl on the moon.
Not a man on the moon?
No, a girl on a tree. You know Rona and the Moon? But I thought it was science because I was like 2.
Watching science on TV sort of ruined all that stuff for me.
You watched science shows as a kid?
No. But I watched a lot of sci-fi and it sort of ruined fantasy for me.
Right, because aliens are way easier to believe than an elf.
Well, yeah, you can't have both, can you? I mean, the sun can't be the queen of the fire fairies and the mechanically enhanced second home planet of the Zorgots, can it?
I suppose not.
What was your first impression of me?
Small.
This was last year.
We met at that museum, right?
Yeah.
You know, the conference our dads were doing. Hanging out with all those old guys. You were the first young, fresh-faced person I'd seen in what felt like decades. So, yeah. Small. Young. Baby child.
Okay, that makes some sense.
What about your first impression of me?
Small. Just because you are.
Oi.
How is Dr. Kingston?
That's fine. You! We have caught you red-handed!
Oh, it's for a play.
According to flat rule 6...
No, I wasn't
bro.
Out.
Bro!
I'm in a play.
As if.
I put it on the calendar. It's for uni, sort of.
Is it a musical?
What? No, why would it be a musical?
Wait, is this Faustus?
Yeah.
Hey! It's Marlowe.
Oh, you and Marlowe.
No, he's a genius. It's the way his theme of humanity... Okay, fine. Bed Peter, what role did you get?
Faustus.
Hey! Alright, that's great! Fantastic. Good job.
Thanks.
Do you think he's telling the truth?
Don't you?
I don't know, it just all seems so convenient.
What do you mean?
Well, now for however many weeks, Peter has an excuse to be out of the house every night for however many hours.
Fred.
Do we even know that he's in a play?
He said he was in Faustus. He wouldn't lie about
that. But he knows that you love Marlowe. He's just playing you to be a fool.
Fred.
He said he was playing Faust. I mean, it's probably the only character he knows the name of.
It's Faustus.
So what, like a star football jock just ups and leaves to join a musical?
Not a musical.
It just sounds made up.
Look, Pete, whatever his name is, doing acting isn't out of the blue, okay? He didn't do drama at school, sure, but he had to do heaps of speeches and stuff as student leader. This isn't the same thing, but I guess he's just got stage presence.
No, no, he should prove it.
Look, he had red hands. I don't think Peter's the kind of guy to leap about in a bucket of paint at God knows what time.
I don't know, I still think we should investigate.
You sound like some year 10s, I know. Look, maybe we should just... I don't know. Maybe we should just ask him to invite some cast members over.
Okay, I'll do that. He's still getting punished, though. He broke curfew.
Yeah, but it was an extracurricular activity.
He didn't tell me about it.
But it was on the calendar.
So I don't get to punish him?
I don't think this one's justified, Fred.
Oh, he's going to be so smug about it.
I'm just going to have to be the bigger person.
No, I know that he's lying. I will prove it. Prove it.